In this video, we're going to take a look at the control center on the Apple Watch. With the control center, we have access to various controls such as focus, do not disturb, our Wi-Fi settings. We can turn on and off our Wi-Fi. We have a lot of different controls. We can rearrange them. We can even remove them from the control center. If we don't use it, we can remove it from the control center to free up space. Now, in this video, I'm not going to go over the actual controls in detail. I'm just going to show you how you can access the control center and edit them, and I'll give you a brief rundown of each control. So let's go and take a look at the control center on the Apple Watch. Let's go over to my Apple Watch. Now, to access your control center, what you need to do is go down to the very bottom of your Apple Watch display, and then you tap and hold just for a split second and swipe up. So if I tap and hold for a split second and swipe up, I get my control center, and we can see we have various controls here. We can even edit them. To close the control center, what we need to do is just go to the top here, and then we just pull it down. So I just pull this down, and it closes it. So what are these various controls? Well, let's go back down towards the bottom here, and we're going to swipe up, and there's our controls. So up towards the top, what we have here is, if we're connected to our iPhone, this is what the green rectangle is. So this is telling me that my Apple Watch is actually connected to my iPhone. To the right of that, we have our focus, or do not disturb. So right now I am in a specific focus. Below that we have do not disturb or focus. I tap on the crescent moon and I can change my focus mode or just turn on do not disturb. I'm going to tap on cancel. This is how we get out of that. I'm back in my control center. To the right of that we have our battery percentage. So I'm at 69%. We have theater mode. When this is turned on, the display on your Apple Watch will turn off, even if you lift it up to read the time. So how do you turn it back on? All you have to do is just tap the screen. When you tap the screen, your display will turn on. And to turn it back off, all you have to do is just cover it. So if you're in a movie theater, just cover it like this, and then it will turn back off. Let's go back over to my control center. I accidentally turned it off. So that's what theater mode is. I use it a lot when I go to the movies. To the right of that, I have here ping. Now, yours might not be in the same order. We can change how these are ordered. I'll show you that towards the end of the video. So you might not see the same order as what I have here. So what this will do when I tap on this is it'll play sound on my iPhone. My wife uses this almost daily. She can't find her iPhone, but she always has her Apple Watch. So all she has to do is just tap on this, and then her iPhone will make a sound, a pinging sound, and then she can go and find her iPhone. Now below that, what we have is our Wi-Fi. If I want to disconnect from my Wi-Fi, I tap on this. And this is my sounds. If I do not want my Apple Watch to make any sounds, I just tap on this. Right now it is turned on, that's why it is red. So my Apple Watch will not make any sounds. If there's an alarm going off, it will not make a sound. It'll do the haptic tap so I can feel it on my wrist, but it will not make a sound. Below that we have our flashlight. When I tap on this, the Apple Watch will turn into a flashlight, and then you can swipe to the left or right to change the color or the frequency that it is blinking. I use this one when I go for a walk at night when it's dark out. Turn on the flashlight, set it to blinking, just swipe to the left or right to change if you want it to blink. Then as you're walking, people can see that flashing light. We have our walkie-talkie. If you have a friend that has an Apple Watch, what you can do is use a walkie-talkie to communicate with them. I would tap on this, it'll turn yellow, and then what I'm able to do through the app, through the walkie-talkie app, is communicate with another friend. We do not have to call them, it's just a walkie-talkie. Below that, let's go ahead and swipe up. We have airplane mode. This will turn off all your network settings. I can turn on water lock. You'll want to use this when you go swimming, so it'll basically try to prevent the Apple Watch from being damaged if you're swimming. I can select what my audio output is. If I have Bluetooth headphones, I could select which headphones I want to send it to, send the audio to from my Apple Watch. And then I can also check my headphone volume. Let's go ahead and swipe up. I also have text size. This is how I can change the text size. And then if I want to turn announce notifications on and off, I can do that as well. And then our last option here is for our accessibility shortcuts. Now, in other videos, I will be going over some of these features in more detail. I just kind of want to show you what the control center is and the different options you have available here. Now, if you want to edit this, maybe you want to change them around. Maybe you want to have the text size up towards the top. You change the text size quite a bit. Or if you use accessibility, maybe you need to have your shortcuts up towards the top. What we're able to do is edit this. All we have to do is just tap on edit here. And then I can remove different controls, or what I can do is drag them around to move them around. So let's go with my text size. All I have to do is just drag it up. And once I have it where I want, I just let go. And now text size is up towards the top. If I remove a control, let's go ahead and remove focus. Let's say I don't use focus, so I do not want to have this in my control center. All I have to do is just tap on the red circle here. It removes that control from my control center. So now when I push in on the digital crown to save my edits, we can see we do not have my focus control there. But now let's say I want to use that control. How do I add it back in? Well, what we need to do is go down to the bottom. We tap on edit. And then at the very bottom, we have controls that we aren't using. So you're going to see I have here more, and I have school time and focus. So if I wanted to add focus back to my control center, I tap on the green plus, and it adds it to my control, and then I can go and move it around. So I can move it up towards the top if I use focus quite a bit, which is probably what you'll do if you do use focus. You want to have easy access to it. So what you want to do is move it up towards the top, press in on the digital crown to save it, and now we have my focus up there at the top. When you are done, you can just swipe down, or what you can do is press in on the digital crown. When I press in on the digital crown, it does close the control center as well. Now, we cannot change these settings for our control center in the Watch app. We can only do this on the Apple Watch itself. In some cases, or I should say in most cases, what we are able to do is change the settings on either the Apple Watch or in the Watch app on the iPhone. In this case here, for our control center, we can only do that on the Apple Watch. So that is our control center and how we can edit it on the Apple Watch.